Hello friends, welcome back. Today we'll discuss about taxonomy. It's a classification of all living organisms. The literary meaning of taxonomy is the law of arrangement. So how you arrange certain things, so that particular pattern, that particular process is called taxonomy. It's a science of classification of organism to construct international standards and share the classifying system among all the scientific community and everyone, so that there is a uniformity how a nomenclature of organism takes place. In this classification, organisms are grouped in on the basis of certain resemblance, certain characteristics, they are grouped together. For example, when you go to a grocery shop, so it is divided into different zones. For example, grocery, vegetables, meat, your fish. So that classification has certain, some brands are there, certain group of brands are there. So that's how the organism categorization also takes place. This was introduced by, developed by 18th century Swedish botanist Carlos Linnaeus. And he introduced the binomial nomenclature system, a system which gives each organism its name, its genus, and a species name. So in the coming slides we'll discuss more about this. Then each system has a categories. So this taxonomic categories are the different ranks of grouping of the organism, and the collection of the various categories forms a hierarchy. So there are different categories, they form certain hierarchy they form. So that's how the complete categorization or nomenclature of organisms take place. This was done by the botanist Carlos Linnaeus. So taxonomy, a taxon is a group of organisms as a unit on the basis of certain resemblance or difference from the known forms. So they are grouped together, for example like insects. So they are three pairs of joint legs, so they are grouped together. So flowering plants with root system, stem, leaves, so they are grouped together. Now we come to taxonomical hierarchy. So there are 8 ranks or 8 categories we can say. First is domain, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. So these are the 8 ranks. We'll see in details or some brief in coming slides with some examples. Each categories or each rank. It's like a pyramid. So domain forms the base of the pyramid or the inverted pyramid, you can say. So this is more generalized. Then there's a kingdom is there, then phylum is there. So as you go to the tip of the pyramid or inverted pyramid, the end comes the species. So that can be further divided into subspecies. So that's how the complete categorization takes place. The first is the domain. A domain is the highest and most general rank of organism. This rank was introduced in 1990. So earlier the kingdom was the basically the base of the categorization, but now domain was introduced in 1990. It has bacteria, that is prokaryotic, there is no nucleus membrane, so it's a single cell organism. Archaea is a prokaryotic. The only difference between both of them is that it has more of complex RNA polymerase. Then you have eukaryota. So these have other organism which is having nucleus enclosed within membranes. So that's how these 3 has been divided. That becomes a domain. Then we have kingdom. Before domain was introduced, kingdom was the highest hierarchy of classification. So different kingdoms were Animalia, Plantae, Fungi, the Protista, Archaea and Bacteria. Carlos Linnaeus distinguished into 2 mainly, the Animalia and Plantae. So the Plantae, maybe Vegetabilia for the plants. So he divided on the basis of nutrition and the locomotion. So that's the mobility. So plants are not mobile, animals are mobile. So that's how the broad classification of this kingdom was done by Carlos Linnaeus. Then we come to phylum. The phylum is the next rank of after in kingdom. And it's more specific than kingdom, but less specific than class. So if you say after phylum, the class comes, but that becomes much more specific. So there are 35 phyla in the kingdom. Animalia includes chordata, all organisms with dorsal nerval cord. Porifera, sponges, the arthropoda, arthropods. So they are classified on the basis of certain resemblance or grouping. So in a plant, we can say we use the similar characters assigned to one category called division. So we use the word division also in plants. Now the class which comes after phylum, which is much more specific. This was a more general rank proposed by Linnaeus. There are 108 different classes in the kingdom Animalia, include mammalia, mammals, apes, birds, reptilia, reptiles, etc. So in the class, there are orders like primata, monkey, gibbon, carnivora, tiger, cat, dog. So within the class, there are a lot of orders. So in the next, it will be orders will be coming. So class classification is less used in botany, and it's less frequently used, and it's more used in the kingdom Animalia. The order is more specific than class and less than family, and differed on the basis of aggregate of characters. So we have plant family, Convolvulaceae, Solanaceae, order Polyminiates, based on the floral character. So this is the character which is resembled. So they are divided, they are categorized under this family, and that comes on this particular order. There are 1926 orders in Mammalia like primates, cetaceans, whales and dolphins, carnivores, chiroptera, so that bats. So that all comes under the order. So order has certain families under it. The family is more specific than order, classified and less similarities than genus. So it comes in between order and the genus, the family. For example, order Carnivora, it has 12 families. So you have Canidae, Felidae, Ursidae. So you have Canidae has dogs, wolves, foxes, cats, bear. Ursidae has bears. In a plant, is characterized by vegetative and reproductive features. So these are the how it is grouped, vegetative and reproductive features. For example, in genera Solanum, Petunia, Datura, plays on the family Solanaceae. So Solanaceae has these three genera. Genus. This is by naming the scientific name of the organism, genus is used. It's a unique name, and it's more even more specific than family. First part of the organism scientific name in a binomial nomenclature. This is very important. It forms the first name, and the second name is the species name. The scientific name is always italicized, and the genus name is capitalized, while the species name is not capitalized. So this is how the nomenclature of the scientific name of any organism takes place. Genus and species, the only taxonomical ranks that are the written in italics. The example of scientific name human is Homo sapiens. So this in italics. Homo is the genus name, and species is the sapiens is the species name. So this might change, but this remains unique. Species. So that's one of the top most of the pyramid, where you reach the more similarities, more uniqueness reaches there for any organism. So the group of organisms with certain considerable similarities, it's very close to each other. Species are more specific to major taxonomic rank. Species are sometimes divided into subspecies. So sometimes a species that certain species have their own subspecies also there. So there are estimated around 8.7 million different species of organisms in the Earth. The genus name is unique. Now this 8.7, it keep on increasing as we get new species, new organisms we get. So nomenclature keep on increasing. The genus name is unique. The same species name is given different organism. Now I'll just explain with the example. Now what all we studied, I'll just put it in. For example, of this dog, I just got it from somewhere. So it has a domain, eukaryota, animalia kingdom, chordata, comes into phylum chordata, class mammalia, it's a mammal, carnivores, it has canine, based on the canines, it has protein carnivora, canidane, canis, canis lupus, and canis lupus family. So this is the subspecies. So this forms the name of that particular dog or the organism. Suppose we put in a certain pyramid, if we put, so we get a hierarchy like this. So this forms the base of the pyramid, which is much more broader, generalized. So we have plants also here, insect, fish, rabbit, everything. So as you go up in the hierarchy, you see, when it comes to animalia, there are no plants. The chordata, only chordates are there. Then you have mammalia, mammals are there. Carnivore, only carnivores are there. So as you go up in the hierarchy, it becomes specific. And at the last, you'll find the name of the particular dog, the Caris lupus familiaris, which forms the subspecies name or exact name of the particular organism. So that's how. This will help you to understand and keep it in your mind while during examination. This brief small, which help you to visualize and give the correct answers. We just have to remember how it is placed in the hierarchy. Here are three questions. You just have to go through the questions, answer these questions in the comment section. Which taxonomical rank is more specific than order, but less specific than genus? So this question, the general questions, is out of your understanding. You can just write down in the comment box. What is the binomial nomenclature? What is the difference between taxonomical hierarchy and taxonomical rank? So you just have to put some details there, and I'll be replying on all the queries in this particular session. Thank you, students.